Hi, Frankie Schaeffer. This is Jason. My website is jasonburnspreacher.com. And my Twitter, you can get to my Twitter, you can get to my Facebook. And this is a personal message to Frankie Schaeffer. I did a video a few weeks ago about Frankie, did you know your father? And I was watching a video of yours today, and it was about hope for former evangelicals like me. That was the title of your video. And it came across to me that you're hurting, that you're bitter, that you're determined to destroy the legacy of your father. Your father was a great man. Your father was a godly man. Your father was, he was a great man, and he was a godly man, and he was a great strategic thinker, and you contradict yourself. You go on about, oh, evangelicals have got a bad history, evangelicals mess children's heads up and all the rest of it. But your whole ethos is contradictory. You attack evangelicalism with the same hatred that you accuse them of. And so what I see here is there's a lack of intellectual honesty. That you haven't really understood the intellectual issues. You haven't really grasped the intellectual issues, that basically a lot of the things that you're holding on to, you've not got a proper intellectual foundation for. So rather than actually defend your case, to defend your position in rational debate, all you can do is throw out invective and attack evangelicals and rubbish your father's legacy. Your father would be weeping in his grave if he could hear the way you're talking. Your father never did the things that you seem to think that he did. You're implying that he brought you up in a way that he brainwashed you. He didn't brainwash you. Francis Schaeffer made people think. He encouraged people to think. You were not brainwashed. And it's intellectually dishonest, and it's not right that you're telling the whole world that your father brainwashed people. He didn't brainwash his children. He didn't brainwash you. The fact is, you're struggling with inadequacy of yourself. There are things within your own life that you feel inadequate about. And rather than be honest about it and upfront with yourself and upfront with everybody else, you're taking it out on your father. You're taking out the frustration and the anger out on your father. And all your father ever wanted for you is, all he wanted for you is to love you. All he ever wanted for you was to be there for you. We're not perfect. He wasn't perfect. When nobody's perfect. He made mistakes. But you need to look into your heart, and you need to stop this vigilante attack upon evangelicalism and upon your father. And you need to stop telling lies, because what you're saying is lies. What you're saying is untrue. What you're saying is unrighteous. It's so unjust and it's so unrighteous what you're saying. If your position is right, why don't you debate somebody like William Wayne Craig or somebody and provide your position and provide, show that your position is correct, is the right position to take. But all you're doing is throwing out attack and venom. And it has to stop. It has to stop, Frankie Schaeffer. It has to stop. Because the only person really you're damaging is yourself. Because inside you, you are not a happy man. Inside you, you are cut up about something. Something inside you is eating away. And because it's eating away, you are angry and hateful towards your father and his heritage. And it has to stop. And the blame is with you. The blame is with you. You've got to look at yourself. What is it that's fueling this anger? What is it that's fueling this hatred towards your own heritage, your father's heritage? You don't understand that heritage. You haven't fully grasped the intellectual foundations of that heritage. You never fully understood that heritage, and you never fully understood the foundations of that heritage. And all you're in a sea of confusion. You really don't know where you stand on other thing, on a number of things. And your position is intellectually vacuous. You couldn't defend your position because your positions are all over the place. You're hurting. But your hurting has to stop, because it's harming not only evangelicalism, but it's harming you. You've got to come to terms with yourself. There's something in you that you have to come to terms with. And there is a God, and you need to be in relationship with Him. And you're fighting it. You're either fighting it because you want to live your way, you want to do your thing, you want to do things wrong that are not right, so you're determined to bring down evangelicalism because you want to live the way you want to live and do it the way you want to do it and live in sin and justify it. Frankie, I'm asking you, please, please repent. Please come to the Lord who died on a cross for you and shed his blood for you. Find that love for you at the cross and be a champion of the faith like your father was, and stand up for the gospel and tell people that you renounce all this stuff that you're saying, all this attacking evangelicalism, attacking your father's heritage, attacking your own father's character. You need to stop it, bro. And you need to come to the love of Christ. The Lord loved you. I love your father. I never had the privilege of meeting him, but I love him. He helped me so much in my life. He taught me to think. He didn't brainwash me. His writings taught me to think. His writings helped me to be strong in the faith. His writings helped me so much in my life, and helped me to move away from atheism and to become a Christian and to know that the Lord is salvation, that the Lord is the truth. I'd be an atheist if it wasn't for your father. And you need to come to the Lord, you need to find Him, you need to turn to Him, you need to trust Him, you need to find that love. There's a love there. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, Frankie, please, 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 stop it. Stop it, please, and realize that the love of Christ for you, that Christ loved you and He died for you. Stop fighting it. Stop being angry. Stop being bitter. Stop it, Frankie, and just find the peace of God in your life. Find the Lord Jesus Christ, who laid down His life for you, shed His blood for you. For though I speak in the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity, I have become a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains and have not charity, I am nothing. Though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned and have not charity, it profiteth me nothing. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up, doth not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Charity never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I speak as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know, even as also I am known. And now by the faith, hope, charity, these things, but the greatest of these is charity. You know, love is at the heart of the Christian faith because Christ died for us. He showed us his love for us. And Frankie, that is the love that Christ showed you. He gave his life. He was nailed to that cross and he shed his blood. He took your punishment for you. That is reality, and you're running from that reality. You're running from that gospel. You're running from that good news. And it doesn't matter how many videos you make. It doesn't matter how much attack you make on evangelicalism. I can tell you this. I will never, ever, ever, Frankie, I will never, ever, ever renounce your father or his teaching. Never. I stand with your father and his teaching, and I stand on the things that he said about the Christian faith. I stand with your father, and I will never, ever, ever renounce him or the message that he proclaimed. Never in a million years, because it's the truth, Frankie. And not you nor anybody could ever convince me, because your arguments are weak and they're putrid and they don't have any intellectual weight whatsoever. You're the one that wants to live in the ambivalence. You're the one that wants to say that one minute you believe in God and another minute you don't, and it's like a marriage. You're the one that said that. And yet at the same time, who walks in postmodernism is a modernist when you attack Christianity, which is a contradiction in terms. I'm ambivalent, I'm not sure about things, postmodern, but evangelicalism is totally evil. Modernism. Contradicting yourself. You haven't any intellectual foundation or any intellectual consistency. Postmodernist, modernist. Which one are you, bro? Give me your arguments for gay marriage. Go ahead, try and convince me. You won't be able to convince me. What about the is-ought distinction? How do you deal with that? How do you deal with is-ought distinction if you believe evolution, and evolution is your base for making ethics? There's no way in a million years you're going to get around the problem. You have no intellectual foundation whatsoever. You're not willing to engage, you're not willing to debate. All you're willing to do, you're not willing to think through your position. All you're willing to do is to attack and to rubbish and throw insults against your father's people and heritage. I'm not saying they're perfect. I'm not saying they've got it all right. I know it can things can be wrong, and people can be wrong and treat people wrongly. I know there can be an ugliness amongst Christian people in the way they conduct themselves. But that doesn't mean Christianity is not true. Frankie, please, please, what is it with you? Why are you like this? Why, Frankie? You're hurting me. It breaks my heart when I'm hearing Francis Schaeffer's son attack evangelicalism, attack his own father. It breaks my heart, bro. It breaks my heart, mate. Because what you're doing is wrong, and it's not only wrong, you can't back it up. You've got no intellectual ability to back it up. You're not giving us cogent arguments. You're not giving us intellectual reasons for why you have moved from one position to another. All you're doing is just throwing out anger and bitterness towards your father and his heritage and his people. You must, to say that children who are brought up in evangelical homes are brainwashed, that is nasty, it is cruel, and it is vicious to say that. To say that Christians, because they don't believe in evolution or gay rights or whatever, they're not walking in the facts. Prove it. Don't just say it, but prove it. Now, you can't prove it. You can't give us the evidence. If you're walking in fact, then show us the fact. Why would you walk with hate? Why would you walk with anger? If I come to some traffic lights, and I know it's a fact that red means stop and green means go, and it's a busy road, and if I stop at the red, I'm going to be safe. If I go when it says green, I'm going to be okay. But if I ignore the signs, I'm not going to be okay. And a friend of mine comes along, and they just ignore the signs. And I tell them, you're going against the facts. It says stop. You need to stop. It's red light. Stop. Why would I want to be bitter against them? My heart would go out to them. I would have compassion for them. I would have love for them and think, you know what? You're going to go across a red light. You're going to get knocked over. It's a busy road. But you're doing the exact opposite. People are going, in your estimation, are going over the red light. They are moving in evangelicalism, and according to you, it's wrong. But you're not showing any love. You're not showing any compassion to them. So it shows that you are full of bitterness, and there's something wrong with you in your own life, Frankie. Your father was a loving man. One of the reasons why I became a Christian is because I never met him, but I felt a real love come from that man. And that was one of the reasons why I became a Christian. I became a Christian because of two men, Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones and Francis Schaeffer. Those are the two men that inspired me to become. I would not have become a Christian if it was not for Francis Schaeffer, if it was not for Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones, I would never have become a Christian. It was because I knew that Francis Schaeffer was a man of God, that he loved God. It was because of his intellectual brilliance and the things that he was saying that really helped me to understand my place in the world and help me to make sense of everything. And Lloyd-Jones' preaching brought me to salvation, Frankie. And I can tell you now, I am not going down the political correct way. I am not going down the evolutionary way. Nobody's ever proved to me at all, nobody's ever proved to me how mutations and natural selection produce the change of variety that we have today over millions of years. We can show that there's change in time, but we can't show over millions of years how things have changed. We can't do that as far as I'm concerned. It's mathematically just totally impossible. Gay rights and things like that. You cannot argue and give me a cogent argument how you get out of the is-ought distinction. No chance. This book feeds me spiritually, strengthens me, renews me. It tells me about Jesus Christ. It tells me about the way to heaven. I've read many philosophy books and theology books and all sorts of literary books, but this book never grows old. It always grows newer and newer and vibrant and refreshes my soul. And I will never, ever, 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 I will never, ever renounce the gospel. And I will never turn my back on Christ. And I will never turn my back on your father's heritage. Never. I don't care if the whole of America becomes politically correct. I don't care if all of America follows your view, your opinions, because they are not right. They cannot be intellectually defended. All you're doing is propagating dogma and pushing dogma on people because you're not willing to defend it intellectually. All you're willing to do is attack. And to say that evangelicals who bring their children up, brainwash them, that's attack. That's attack. That's not being an intellectual. That's just pure, downright intolerance and attack, Frankie. There's no culture or intellectual sophistication when you take that kind of tact and that argument. It's vicious and it's nasty and it's intolerant. And it shows you the kind of intolerance that there is within political correctness in America. You're not all sweetness and light. You want to turn the heart out of Christianity in America. And so that's what you're doing. Attack the families. And wrench the kids away from their families. As if you're doing a great thing, when in fact all you're doing is judging families. You don't know tens of thousands of Christian families. You're just making an assumption. And there's no way in a million years that your father brainwashed you. You were not brainwashed. Your father taught people to think. So basically, I'm just telling you, Frankie, that you can say anything you want. You can say anything you want. And maybe hundreds of young people will follow you, but this person, me, I'll never follow what you're saying. I'll never believe what you're saying. I believe what your father says. I believe what your father wrote. I believe his life, his legacy, is a million times better than your life and your legacy, the way you're pumping out hatred and anger and pumping out nonsense that you're pumping out against your father and against evangelicalism. I'm standing with your father, and I'm standing with his, with the heritage of the gospel. And I'll never, ever, 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 ever move in a million years to your point of view, because your point of view is intellectually vacuous, bro. All you're doing is playing on people's prejudice, and all you're doing is brainwashing people. You're brainwashing people because I don't see you debating, having proper debates. I don't see these politically correct people wanting debates. I see them rioting at Berkeley and stopping people having free speech at Berkeley with Milo and any other person who differs from them. I don't see free speech there, bro. So it's you who's brainwashing the political correct brigade with their platforming at universities where they won't allow certain types of people to come and lecture or give talks. It's you're the ones who control the media and stop a different opinion. You're the one, your side is the one that wants to change Facebook and YouTube and these places and call everything fake news so that you can shut down any other opinion than from what you want to propagate. I'm just here to tell you, bro, that there's one guy here right now, ain't moving, ain't budging. I'm standing under the gospel, I'm standing for the gospel, I'm preaching the gospel, I'm lifting up Christ, and I would encourage everybody else to lift up Christ. And I would ask people to take no notice of Frankie Schaeffer, because what he's saying is a load of nonsense. And I hope that one day you get along, Frankie, and you begin to weep for what you've said, and you begin to be sorry for what you've said. You begin to realize that what you've said is out of order. It's not right, bro. You're strawmanning your father's arguments. You're strawmanning evangelicalism. You're picking on the worst of things, and, you know, there's, of course, I'm not saying that things are perfect. I know that things, attitudes can be not right sometimes amongst God's people. I know that politics in America's got ugly and is getting ugly on the right and the left. And evangelicals can be just as bad. I'm not saying they're perfect. I'm not saying their leaders are perfect. I'm sure many of them have done things that they shouldn't be doing. So I'm not excusing behavior that is not godly. But does that give you an excuse to walk in bitterness? To propagate lies about your father and about evangelicalism? Does that make you an authority on evangelical teaching when you don't really understand it? You've never really understood it? You're hurting. You're really, 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 really hurting. There's something inside you, I don't know what it is, but there's something inside you that's cutting you up. I don't know what it is. But it's like an anger in you that you will not give up. That you are going to be determined to push it to the very end. And nothing is going to stop you. You are going to push and push and push. I want to tell you that I'm going to be praying for you. Every day, you're going to be on my prayer list, Frankie. And I'm going to be praying for you every day. And I want to tell you, Frankie, I love you. I want to tell you I love you. I think you're an amazing guy. I think you're an amazing guy. And I love you, mate. I think you've been blessed with a wonderful family. I think you've got amazing talents and gifts. And I just hope one day you realize that the way you're behaving towards your father, towards the heritage that he stood for, is totally out of order. I'm going to pray for you. I love you. And I make this video because you're so determined and you're so strong-minded that I just felt I had to confront you. And I had to show you that there's someone as stronger-minded as you, but in a different direction. That the will that you have and the strong will that you have to be determined to go the direction of your liberalism, that someone has matched you, that I'm on the other side and I'm standing for your father's heritage and I'm standing for what he says. And if you want to debate and discuss, if you want to have a dialogue and a discussion on a Google Hangout and a debate on the heritage of your father and whether it has intellectual sense for today, you want to debate that, I'm happy to engage with you. But I'm standing, I'm just showing you that I'm as determined as you are, but on the other opposite side, I'm going to be standing up for your father, and I'm going to be standing up for his heritage. And every time you attack your father, every time you spew out something negative about evangelicals, I'm going to make a video and I'm going to call you out. Because it can't be left, you can't be just left, you just spewing out stuff and it's not being challenged. Alright, I'm going to pray. Father, I just thank you for this day, and I thank you for your love and mercy, and I give you the praise and glory. And Father, I thank you for Francis Schaeffer and Edith Schaeffer and the Schaeffer family. What a family, what a great blessing they've been to me. Edith Schaeffer's books, Edith Schaeffer's ministry, Francis Schaeffer's books, Francis Schaeffer's ministry. I owe them an incalculable debt, and many thousands of people owe them an incalculable debt, and I thank you for all the amazing love and amazing things that they did, and I just thank you for them, Lord. And Lord, I thank you for Frankie Schaeffer. I don't know where his heart is, Lord, you know him. And I just pray, Lord, that you would just touch his heart, and I pray that he would just know your love. And I just pray that you speak to him, Lord. I pray that you'd open his heart. And I pray that, Lord, he'd repent. And he'd just come back to you, Lord, and find that love that you have for him, that you died on that cross for him. I just pray he would find that love, and he would find that peace, and he would find that joy, and he would find that comfort in you. And I just pray that he'd be a mighty man of God, and that he would defend the gospel. Father, bless him, provide for him and his family, bless him beyond his wildest dreams, and Father, use him for your glory, bless him for your glory, and may be a champion of the faith again, like his father. Father, please, touch his heart. Fill him with your love. Fill him with the love of Christ. Melt his heart. And show him your love, Lord, and your grace. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, Frankie, I hope that's made you think, and I've been strong because I just feel you're so strong-minded and so determined. I just felt I had to show you that people are stronger, just as strong on the other side. But it comes from a concern for you and a love for you, and a love for your father and a love for the heritage that means so much to me. And I just pray that this video might make you think. It might make you reconsider and go over your strategy of what you're doing. And I just hope that you might come back to the Lord and begin to defend the faith. I'm asking you to do that. And I just pray that the Lord will bless you. All right. God bless you. Take care. Thank you.